I'm Dr. Cathy Williams. I'm a professor here in the School of Animal Sciences. I serve as the curriculum coordinator of our program. Our major is animal sciences, but within that major we have four concentrations: animal production, animal products processing, science and technology, and pre-veterinary medicine. Our Animal and Food Sciences Laboratories building, which houses research labs, a classroom, and faculty offices. And right behind me here is Francione Hall, which is another component of our animal science program. And with that, we're going to go into the animal science building, Francione Hall, and I'd like to introduce Mr. Boo Persica, and I'm going to turn it over to Boo.
Yeah, thank you, Kathy. How you doing? So my name is Boo Persica, and I'm a research associate here at the School of Animal Sciences, and I run the meat lab at LSU, which is part of our animal products concentration. So we'll walk through the building right here in Francione. I'll give you a little history about the building and what goes on in there and what experiences you can expect to get. So the meat lab will actually start behind me down this hallway. We are a state-inspected meat facility at Harvest's Livestock, does meat production, further processing, and also teaching and research in the animal science program. All right, so you're in room 131, J.B. Francione Hall. Carcasses will take place, but we'll break down carcasses into wholesale, then into retail cuts. We actually take class in this room with product in front of us at the time. Across from room 131 is our cooler hall that has a bank of commercial grade coolers where we hold our products. In there is where we'll chill carcasses that are harvested. And this is livestock that animals raised, and we'll go through the process of fabrication in room 131 and on to the dairy store.
Okay, so now that we've taken a tour of J.B. Francione Hall, we're going to go into our other part of our animal sciences facilities, which would be the Animal and Food Sciences Laboratories building. Okay, we're in the main lobby of the Animal and Food Sciences Laboratories building. Now, this building houses animal sciences, of course, as well as nutrition and food sciences, too. So they have laboratories and offices in the building, as well as the animal sciences program. Now we're in the genetics and disease laboratory, where Dr. Richard Cooper and his graduate students and undergraduate researchers work in the development of vaccines for several of our very important livestock diseases. Now, as some of the courses that we offer are special topics type courses, independent study type courses that are geared toward research, and if students are interested in that type of course in the study of genetics and diseases, this would be an opportunity for some hands-on experience in a laboratory. So now we're on the second floor of the Animal and Food Sciences Laboratories building, also called the AFSL building. And upstairs in the building, we have quite a few research laboratories. We have a physiology laboratory where we do hormone analyses on animal samples. We have a muscle biology laboratory, a meat science laboratory, a nutrition laboratory, as well as a reproductive physiology and embryology laboratory. We also have quite a few opportunities for undergraduate research in nutrition, reproduction, physiology, meat science, and muscle biology. So if that's something that you think you might be interested in later on, you can partner with a faculty member and some graduate students in any of those areas that may seem of interest to you, and do your own undergraduate research and see what it's all about. We're here in the conference room on the second floor of the AFSL building. And up here on the second floor, in addition to the labs we've toured, we also have our faculty offices where you could come meet with your course instructor if you have a question, and your faculty advisor. And you may want to meet with your advisor if you find that you need to talk about dropping a class, you're having trouble, they're there to help you. And also when it's time to prepare your schedule for the next semester, it's a really good idea to meet with your faculty advisor and go over the courses you plan to take. So up here on campus, in addition to our Animal and Food Sciences Laboratories building and the Francione building, we also have the Dairy Science building, which houses our creamery and our dairy store. So in the creamery, we make cheese, ice cream, and bottled milk, and make eggnog during the holiday season. And then those products are sold in the dairy store, which students, faculty, staff, and even people from the general public can get onto campus and buy the products. Now, where does the milk come from to make the products on campus? the Southeast Station Research Dairy in Franklinton, Louisiana. It's about 90 miles from here, but at that farm, which is associated with the Animal Science Department and the LSU Ag Center, we have a herd of Holstein cows, which are milked, and the milk for the products here comes from the cows at our dairy in Franklinton. Also, the dairy is a source of hands-on activities for our students, because some of our farm animal practices courses and dairy management course, we do take students to Franklinton during the class to get some hands-on activities with the dairy cattle. Now, back here in Baton Rouge, we have our central research station, Benher Farm. In our farm practices course, there's laboratories where you go out to the farm and learn how to handle these animals, give injections, or learn how to put tags in cattle. And in addition to using these animals for our courses, we also have our undergraduate and graduate research projects going on utilizing these animals. So we have a lot of things going on at the farm, in the building, in the creamery. So there's lots and lots for you to do here in the School of Animal Sciences. So we are really spread out here with all of our different animals. It's a very large farm out here at the Benher facility. You can see a couple of our cattle here. We have about 350 head of cattle here, purebred and crossbred. And the cattle here again are used for our teaching and research purposes, our livestock judging class, our animal management practices class, and our beef cattle production class as well. So behind me are some of our horses at our horse unit here at the Benher Farms. And the horse unit is pretty big. It goes from where I'm standing back here all the way across the road. And there's more horses and barns and facilities for students to do research. And we have our equine courses out there as well. So here we have three of our young pigs that were born back in March. And these pigs are part of the unit here where we have animals for teaching and a little bit of research. But these animals right here were saved to be used in our classes coming up this fall, our livestock judging class, as well as our animal management practices course. So students will learn how to evaluate the pigs, maybe do some hands-on management practices and techniques with them. So these are some of our goats out here at the small ruminant farm. These goats were born back in the spring. They'll be used in some of our classes, again, the management practices course, the small ruminant production course, and the livestock evaluation course. In addition to the goats that you see here, we do have a flock of sheep. So we have sheep and goats that are kept here for research and teaching purposes year round. Okay, so now we're at the poultry unit, which is at the Benher facility across the road from where we've seen the beef cattle and the sheep and goats. And out here at the poultry unit, we have grower houses and layer houses. And also behind me is the feed mill where they actually mix the feedstuffs that we feed the chickens here. We can't go inside these buildings because it's a very biosecure facility. The facility here is used for classes, for our poultry judging class, our poultry management class, our poultry biology class, as well as research for our undergrad students, as well as some graduate students. Out here at the facility, we also have a classroom inside where the eggs are harvested from the houses and brought inside for processing, put into cartons for later sale. So in addition to these units here, we have two additional animal units. One of them is our Reproductive Biology Center, which is in St. Gabriel. Now our other animal unit is the dairy farm, which is the Southeast Research Station in Franklinton, Louisiana, which is about 90 miles away. So when we have classes there or field trips to see the dairy, we do take the students in vans and get you there and bring you back.